Welcome everyone to the Azure Data Engineer Interview Preparation Series by GrowthX Academy. In our last interview video, we covered how you can handle incremental data loads in Azure Data Factory. On that video, one of you asked a very good follow-up interview question, and we're here to break it down. Next question is, what if your source table doesn't have a reliable timestamp column? How do you still manage incremental data loading efficiently? Let's answer this question in 2 minutes. Do watch it till the end. Also, please hit the like button on this video. We are hoping 100 likes as target for our motivation. Let's start the answer. So in cases where the source table doesn't have reliable timestamp columns like inserted date or updated date time, my approach would be based on the primary key values combined with a control table strategy using hash values. I would create a separate control table in the target system. This control table would contain two columns, the primary key like EmployeeeID, and a hash value generated from the rest of the columns in the table, for example, name, department, ManagerID, salary, etc. Now, when the data pipeline runs, it would compare each primary key value from the source table with the corresponding primary key in the control table. For each match, I would compare the hash values as well. If the hash values match, it means the record has not changed and it can be skipped. If the hash values differ, it indicates the record has been updated, so it would be treated as an incremental update. If the primary key doesn't exist in the control table, it's a new record and will be inserted into the target. This approach works effectively when there's no timestamp data available for incremental loads. However, I do want to point out that having a table without standard timestamp columns like created date or last updated date isn't a great database design from a compliance and auditing perspective. So I would definitely recommend to the architecture team that they consider adding proper timestamp columns. It not only simplifies incremental loads, but also ensures data governance and audit point of view. That's generally how I handle such scenarios. That's it. This is how you can answer. Thank you for watching till end. We hope it is helpful, and if yes, do hit on like button. We kept a target of 100 likes so that we are motivated. Also, do comment any interview questions that you want to get answers. Check out for our 40-day one-to-one Azure Data Engineer training, where you will execute the things than simply learning theory. Try it out for 5 days free of cost. Thank you.